Welcome to another tutorial on MATLAB. In this series, we are looking into the concept of stateflow and how it is implemented in MATLAB. Sometimes question comes that what is the difference between the stateflow and Simulink? Why I will be using Simulink rather than Stateflow, and why I will be using Stateflow rather than Simulink? This is a confusing question, so let's analyze where we will be using these two tools. So where we will be using Stateflow: when the system involves change in the parameter due to which the behavior of the system changes abruptly, then in that case we can use Stateflow as a tool to define those states, like at which time instant the behavior will change. If the parameter changes, then what could be the possible next behavior? That could be the next state. For example, if I have a rocket which I am going to launch into the sky, then in that case the rocket has different stages. At different stages, it will drop the mass that it has carried for a certain distance, and the mass will suddenly disappear, due to which the rocket weight changes. And based on this, the consumption of fuel will also change. This is because the thrust needed to push the rocket to upward is now less compared to the previous state, because the mass has changed from one particular mass to another mass, M2 suppose, due to the staging. The staging process happened and the mass changed suddenly. So in such scenarios, we will be using Stateflow, where there will be multiple states possible for a particular system. Next question comes, like, where should I use Simulink? Simulink can be used for continuous system. If a system is continuously varying with time and there is no abrupt change that is happened in the system, then in that case I will be using Simulink. Consider a chemical reaction which is present over here. If I put or mix two chemicals, the chemical reaction will happen continuously over time, and there will be no abrupt change in the state unless there is a catastrophic reaction. In this case, I will be using Simulink because the system is varying continuously and it has no abrupt change involved in it. So when there is states present in the system as a whole, then we will be using Stateflow into account. And when there is a continuous variation, like some integration or differentiation that is happening continuously for the system to solve over time, then in that case I will be using Simulink. I hope this will help to see and understand where we will be using Simulink and where we will be using Stateflow in MATLAB. In case you are liking our channel, please consider subscribing and press on the bell icon for latest updated notifications. In case you have any comment or suggestions, please share it in the comment box so that we can improve your experience of learning MATLAB in the channel. Happy learning MATLAB!